having a good level of code coverage is a desired result for almost project manager or product owner. It's so because no one wants to release a new version of a product and then receives a lot of complaints about problems that were introduced by this new version. And a way to minimize that is testing with automated tests your software, but we need to automate a proper coverage of the code for ensure there is not part of the codes that were not tested. And for that purpose, there are some frameworks, some libraries, like JEST here, in which we have this, you can take a look here, this coverage parameter, in which will report to us what parts of the code we are not covering. And now we are going to take a look how to use the JEST test with coverage parameter and how to analyze its outputs to know if we can increase the code coverage of our tests. So let's start that. Before producing the whole project from zero, let me explain to you what is the outputs we receive. When we run the test from console, we have a report here that show like a table that run over all mapped files, all the files that were covered by the tests, and showing the percentage of lines that are covered. In this case, we have 100% of code lines covered by the tests. And more than have the results here in the terminal output, JEST also produces one report in a visual manner, in a graphical manner, based in one HTML file it produces. As you can see here, this coverage folder was created automatically by JEST. And here there is one HTML file that is going to display the whole outputs here, and we have the same result as we had in the server in the console of Visual Studio here in a graphical manner. So now we are going to build that from zero and reach the same point here. Here we have one empty folder that was just created and then opened with Visual Studio. Then I have opened the terminal from Visual Studio in the same folder we have just created. First step, we need to instantiate the new node project with the famous instruction npm init minus y. Then it is going to create the new project without ask many things. Okay, now we need to introduce one new dependence, that is the JEST library. Okay, so we have just to input here this instruction. Okay, it has one letter more here in front of. Right, npm install, and then this parameter, because this library don't need to go to the production environment later, it's just for this development and maximum integration environments, and then the name of the library, JEST. Doing that, it's going to download the framework we are going to use for testing. So just wait the download to be concluded and we go on. Okay, a few libraries being downloaded. As you should know, once it's downloaded, the node models folder will be created and the dependency will be there. Okay, almost half of the way. the folder already displays here. Okay, it's done. The whole JEST was downloaded. And one last step here. It was printed here in the console when we have created the project, but we have to open this package.json here. As you can see, there is no test script configured, and we are going to change that for the name of the library we are utilizing, JEST. And doing that, what's going to be changed here? Doing that, when we are going to open here our terminal, let me just clear that. And then when we run npm test, it knows it needs to execute the JEST software, the JEST framework. And now it's going to run over all the scripts we have. However, we do not have any script. Actually, we do not have any source code. And that is going to be the next part. Now, we are going to execute the first tests automated with JEST. I already have then introduced here two files I'm going to explain to you. And it's very important to understand the project structure. As you can see in the last instruction we have executed, there is this part of the output here that is a test match. JEST is looking automatically for all files that contains in its name test.js or TypeScript or spec instead of test, but it looks for files with this pattern of name. So our test file is separated from the original file with our logic. So our test file is here. And the original file, it's here. So the content of this file is going to be tested by the code that is inside this file. Okay, but why they are also in separated folders? This folder named source and this folder named test, they could have any another name. This name is not so important, but it's important that your test folder, all the test files are inside one test folder, for instance, or more, and all your source code from your system to be tested is inside another folder. Because when we run the coverage instruction we are going to execute next, we need to point it over which directory. It's going to analyze the coverage. And there is no sense for we has to test the test code and the original code together. So it could make a mess in the understanding of the code. So we separated them. Right. So we have a folder for the original code and a folder for test code. Okay. So the original code, what we have here? Very simple class, name of the product. We are going to register products inside this array. We have a method to add a new product, and we have a method for reading the list of existing products. And we have the product constructor that is going to create a new product with a name and a price. Just that. And then in this case, my unit is going to be the product class. And now we need to have a test for testing that. For this purpose, then we have this test file here. So this syntax here, the test method that has a name and there is a test function, it's the standard way of testing from Node, and of course it's the standard way of testing with JEST. And then here it's going to instantiate the new product, it's going to add the product in the list, it's going to get the list of products, and it's going to evaluate if this output is correct or not, checking if there is one product, we register it. Right, and this code, we expect it really can test all lines of code of my product class, because Because we are going to test the constructor, we are going to test the adding, we are going to test the get, and of course when we do the new product, we execute this initialization as well. So the whole lines of code are tested. And how to test that? Basically, there's a very simple way of testing. We can just clear that again, and we are going to do the same thing we have done, npm test. By doing that, it again is going to look for all the files that match the pattern name, and then it's going to execute the whole test. Okay, we have here one problem. Of course, it says it has failed the execution because product is not defined. So, of course, here is an error of some kind of import or thing like that, so we can just fix it. So here we have the product class, and here we export this product class, and here in the test, here we need to import the product. This part of the code is missing, so we just need to add that again. It's not a big deal. Now we have solved the import of the model we are going to test, and then if we run here again npm test and run that, we can observe then in the output that this test here named adds product is going to be mapped, and its result is here documented, and here's the method name. Now how to know about the coverage of our test? Then we need to execute the npm test with another parameter. So let's do that. And now I'm going to show to you the code that's going to evaluate the test coverage we have. What you have to do is to execute the same solution we have executed previously plus the coverage parameter, and more than that, inform me to the coverage parameter what's going to be the folder it's going to analyze. In my case, the sys folder, named src. In case your project uses another folder name, you just replace that here. Now let's execute that. Okay, looks like we had a problem here. Okay, now it's running, and let's wait for the outputs. As you can see, so we have here this table informing we have covered all the lines, and the test has passed. And as we have seen in the beginning of this video, in the coverage folder that was automatically created, we have then here the HTML report that's showing that in a graphical manner. But let's just do one new test here. In case we, for instance, just comment this line of code. Not by the evaluating if it's going to pass or not, but by evaluating the test coverage. Okay, like if we do not add the product, we are going to take the empty list, it's going to be zero the length, it's going to fail, but it's not just that I would like to show to you. What about the coverage? Let's see how it's going to behave. So let's do the whole stuff again. Let's execute that, await for the output, and then see how it's going to behave. As you can see, now we don't map anymore all the lines of our code, just a part of that. And then we have information about what lines not covered, and then we can fix, we can write more tests for covering this case. So it's that for this video. Thank you for your attention.